أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Have the taqwa of Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, in behalf of the Islamic Center of Colombia, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all. And we praise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the good of this evening and protect us from the evil of that evening. Inshallah, I introduce to you my dear respected brother Mutahir Sabri, the chaplain of the Department of Correction, South Carolina, a member of the Shura, the board of Masjid al-Muslimin Islamic Center, to introduce our program, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all for being here tonight. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. I know we haven't eaten yet, but we can be a little bit more. I don't know if anyone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. Allahu Akbar. I know we're here. Allahu Akbar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الكريم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. It's indeed an honor to be here again another year later to share with you in this very very noble occasion to support the efforts by the Muslim community of Colombia sponsored by the Islamic Center of Colombia the Bantu Youth Summer Program, and tonight's effort is a fundraising event for that purpose. For those of you who do not know, our community a few years ago was blessed with an influx of Muslims from abroad who were known as the Somali Bantu refugee. And after years of having worked with them in the community, with other faith groups, the Islamic Center, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has distinguished itself as being the primary lead effort to assist them in helping to become established here in Columbia, South Carolina. So this occasion tonight is an effort to help raise funds to provide
further services for them. This past summer, we were blessed to have a summer program in unity with the efforts by the Lutheran community. However, this coming summer, the masjid is going to be completely responsible for them. And because there are no funding sources, outside sources that will be funding this effort, then it will be through efforts like this that will, inshallah ta'ala, by the will of Allah, make such programs possible. So we thank all of you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and join with us tonight. And as you can see from your programs, we have a full evening ahead of us. I would like to say and apologize that there have been some modifications to your program. So while you received the program as you came to the event this evening, we're going to be following a slightly altered program. And so if it doesn't follow the program that you received, please forgive us. We'll try to keep you abreast of what's going on as we proceed through the evening. But we have a full event tonight. We're going to hear from the principal of our school, Brother Musa Ramsey, who is the program coordinator for the Somali Bantu Youth Program at the Masjid. And also, we're going to be entertained and enlightened by the youth of our community, from the weekend school, from the Madrasat al-Muslimin, the full-time Islamic school, and from the children of the Somali Bantu community. So we're excitedly looking forward to that, and we hope that you will enjoy the evening. As the evening progresses, we hope that it will soften our hearts so that we will respond to the call to support this effort inshallah in very generous ways. And certainly, lastly but not least, we have a very distinguished guest whom you will be hearing from later in the evening. Sahmuddin Hafiz al-Quran. Sahmuddin Haroon is visiting us, and so we'll be hearing from him later on in the evening. So sit back and relax. I believe that the food is being prepared and the wait for it is well worth waiting for. I know some of you may have been fasting today or you haven't eaten, so you're chomping at the bit. So the food will be brought out in time. I don't know if that's been changed according to the schedule, but before you leave tonight, you'll get to eat, inshallah. So at this time, I'd like to bring to you the director of our school and Shura member, Brother Musa Ramsey. Assalamu alaikum.
Bismillah, inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him, we seek his help and his forgiveness. First and foremost, I would like to thank and welcome each and every one of you for attending our second annual fundraising event. And I would just like to give a brief overview of the BISA program, which is a program that by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are beginning to see it build and actually take momentum as we put more time and we put more effort and put more resources into this program. And I can clearly say that this is one of the main priorities for Masjid al-Muslimin, is to organize an effort for the youth. And for many of you who live in and around the community, you know that we are striving 7 days a week to try to develop programs for our youth, either the full-time school Monday through Friday, the Bantu project on Saturdays, and the weekend Islamic school on Sundays. And this is a great task. And now that we are coming towards the summer, as you all know and have been hearing, that we are very concerned about the idle time that our children are going to be spending within the 8 to 9 weeks on summer vacation. And once again, we want to rise up to the occasion and develop something that is of benefit for them and for us as well. I just want to give a quick idea of what the BISA is, because BISA basically means Bantu / Youth summer activity. And that too slashed youth. If we all can reflect on some of the concerns we had last year, many people, many families came to me and said, it is a very noble effort that we have a program for the Bantu, but what about our children? And we took that into consideration. So this year, we are striving to accommodate the Bantu, which is a duty and responsibility, and our children as well. And we want to strive to bring these two groups together in order for them to benefit and for our children to benefit as well. And this is what we say, our children. All of them are our children. The Weekend Islamic School, Madrasat al-Muslimin, your children, the Bantu children, they are our children, they are our responsibility. I just want to express that the BISA program will be an ideological program. It'll be a program that is designed first and foremost to attract the attention of our youth with recreation throughout the summer. Organized recreation. We already have brothers in place who are going to be organizing teams, football teams, baseball teams, basketball teams, in a very organized and a very beneficial way. And on the same token, we want to also introduce to them all of those principles that Islam presents to us. And we want to also offer education for our youth. So this is what I mean by ideological. Not just play, 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 but integrated into that play and that recreation is our concepts, our principles, and our teachings in order for them to benefit in the best of manners. Now, I'm going to be very brief because we are juggling with the prayer times, Asr and Maghrib, and we have a lot that we would like to offer you this evening. I would just like to say before I stop that this program is building momentum. Right now we have 8 full-time staff members who are ready to work this program for the summer. This is no experiment. We're not scraping, we're not scrambling, we're not trying to organize our resources at the last minute. We've been working and we've been organizing this effort for the last 5 months. We have many brothers and sisters who are qualified and who are very familiar with how to deal with children, and they have come on board. At the same time, we'll be organizing breakfast in the morning and lunch in the afternoon for the children. And we've been successful at organizing transportation for those selected families who need to be picked up and dropped off at the end of the day. So this is a major accomplishment for us. But at the same time, this is normal business for us. This is something that we should be doing. We shouldn't settle for less. And we should have a program in place that accommodates us, our families, regardless of where we're from, our backgrounds, or our strengths and our weaknesses. Now, the last thing I would like to mention is many families came to me last year. And they said, why do we have the Bantu on a separate program? The better program will be to integrate them into the general community. And I said, yes. And then I had other families who came to me and said, why are we focusing so much attention on the Bantu, but we're not focusing any attention on our own youth for the summer? And I said, yes. And the reality is that when we have these lofty ideas and we have these lofty concerns, the fact of the matter is it takes time. So here is 12 months later, and we are ready to do just that, to integrate the Bantu, to accommodate our children. And I'm here to invite you and to encourage you to recognize the fact that this is not a selective type of responsibility. This is a responsibility that rests upon each and every one of our shoulders. It is a collective effort if it is to be successful. And we are striving with our utmost ability to make that reality a reality for all of us. To make that concern a concern for all of us. To make that assertive effort to prioritize, to make it a priority for all of us, in order for that next generation to get what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded that they must get off of our shoulders. So I thank you, brothers and sisters, for attending, And let us look at this event as being a team effort, a collective effort, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to raise the monies that we need to launch this program. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to have a wonderful and a joyous evening as we take in some of the activity. So I'm going to stop here, and we have the Madrasatul Muslimin, 7th and 8th graders. They will come out and they will sing, I believe, one or two songs. And then we're going to really try to alter our schedules. I think there's no explanation. Where you see events occurring on your agenda, if they don't occur, that means they've been altered. Okay? And inshallah ta'ala, we will all be eating after Salatul Maghrib, and we'll be closing out at 9:30.
Can you use the other mic?
No, no, no.
Can it be in the other side?
Pillars of holy.
teaching from the Holy Quran, the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad al-Muqtar. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Brothers and sisters, we all love Rasulullah. Our journey goes on, it's journey for Allah. Forward as Muslims on the sake of Akhirah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Brothers and sisters, we all love Rasulullah. Our journey goes on.
الله أكبر. Yes. Wait, boys.
الله أكبر. Jazakumullah khairan to the youth of our Madrasa Muslimin, the Islamic School in Columbia, Allah Akbar. Did you enjoy that? That was, I believe, a very original work. They wrote that song, Alhamdulillah. And then they had the courage to come up and stand. They didn't write it, I'm sorry. Well, they did a good job singing. They sang it as if they wrote it. So they own it now. Alhamdulillah. Allah Akbar. We're going to hear now from the youth of our Bantu community. And inshallah, they seem very well prepared and ready, so let's give them our full attention. Whatever they're lining up, alhamdulillah. You see their dress very colorfully. And sure, I'm sure that you'll enjoy them as much as we enjoyed the ones you just sang before. Alhamdulillah.
Oh yeah?
Thank you.
Very good. Okay. Thank you. Amen. Very good. Man, this way, boys.
Information I'm giving them makes me want to stick around, you know, and give the best out of what they give me. So,
responsibility as a volunteer teacher. They teach me as well. They laugh at me when I try to pronounce the letter that they have that word. I get bothered. And inshallah, these children benefit from what little I have to give them. May Allah bless you all. Sorry.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ahmed. I'm sure that he speaks on behalf of all of the youth volunteers who work with our Mandarin youth on the weekend. Alhamdulillah, and this is a tremendous opportunity for them to learn community service. So we see a classic example in Brother Dr. Ahmed as he is himself a young student of the madrasa, but he's also becoming aware of his responsibility to the community as he grows older. So he is giving up his time on the weekend, like other students from our community, youth from our community, and we should really encourage him to continue to keep up their good effort. At this time, we want to ask Sister Khalida, if she would, to bring the students from the weekend school to the sophomore high.
Allah, the Prophet, the Prophet Muhammad, the Prophet, the my week in school. I did it for the week before. Alhamdulillah. This is just a snapshot of the efforts that are being undertaken to service the full range of educational needs in our community. And just what you've seen is really the tip of the iceberg, but it requires a tremendous amount of work and dedication on the part of all of the staff that service these children day in and day out. Week in, week out. But while we are about our day in the mall, at work, taking it easy at home, the staff of the full-time school, the staff of the weekend school, and the staff of the Bantu program are diligently sacrificing their time and effort. And we should thank Allah for that. They have taken it upon themselves to relieve us of that collective obligation to help to rear our children, to raise them with the sound Islamic guidance. We ask that Allah's mercy and blessing be upon them, inshallah ta'ala. Well, alhamdulillah, we are right on time according to our schedule. Not your schedule, but our schedule. We have a different schedule for the event. And at this time, we would like to bring before you our special guest speaker, Sheikh Sahmuddin Haroon from Austin, Texas, who is here with us tonight to help us to reach our goal, inshallah ta'ala. And I'm sure that he has some very, very wonderful words of encouragement and enthusiasm to share with us. He is a member of the North American Dance Federation, and he hails from Ghana, alhamdulillah. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless him to be successful here in the efforts of Dawah in America, and we welcome him and ask now that you give your full attention to our guest, Sheikh Sahmuddin Haroon. Assalamu alaikum.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله we praise Allah we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness we seek refuge to Allah تبارك وتعالى from the evils of our own selves and from our bad deeds ومسيب الله تبارك وتعالى guides none can mislead and ومسيب الله تبارك وتعالى mislead there is no guide for it I bear witness and I testify openly that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He is alone without a partner. I also bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and messenger of Allah. All who believe, fear Allah as he ought to be feared and die not except in a state of Islam. O mankind, fear your Lord who created you from a single soul. And created from that soul its mate, and scattered from them both many men and women. And fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut the relations of the wombs that bore you. Indeed, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is Raqib, meaning is ever and all watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and speak always the truth. He will direct you to do righteous good deeds and will forgive you your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has indeed achieved a great achievement. Amma ba'du, certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, Al-Quran. The finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen. And every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, meaning an innovation in the religion. And every bid'ah is astray, and every astray is defiled. I ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to admit us into Jannah and save us from the hellfire. Say Ameen. My brothers and sisters in Islam, إني أحبكم في الله. وأسأل الله العلي القدير أن يجمعنا بكم تحت ظل عرشه ومستقر رحمته يوم الدين. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. I love you all for the sake of Allah. And I ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to join us together on the day of resurrection under the shade of the arsh, the throne. That day there is no shade except the shade of the arsh. The day of resurrection, brothers and sisters, you know better than me. لا يفع مال ولا بنون. The wealth that we possess in this dunya, the wealth that we hoard, the wealth that we keep and we don't spend in the cause of Allah, it will not avail. It will not benefit. Your children, your offspring, they will not benefit except he who comes to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala with pure heart, the heart full of Islam, Iman, perfection and righteous good deeds. Brothers and sisters, to begin with, it is my profound honor to be here with you. And I very much appreciated that my Shaykh, Fadilatul Salih Shaykh Muhammad Adli, invited me. And subhanAllah, I just want to tell you that I am one of the students of the Shaykh. And Shaykh has many students. So I am humbled by this invitation to be here today, inshallah, to participate in this fundraiser. So everything that I say which is correct, it is from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And then it is the fruit and the product of the Shaykh. But any wrong word or any mistake, then it's from me and it is from Shaytan. And we seek refuge to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala from the Shaytan. Let me ask you, brothers and sisters, who wants to be admitted into Jannah? Let me repeat myself again. If you want to go to Jannah, please raise your hand. I want to make myself clear. If you want to go to Jannah, raise your hand. But I am raising two hands, not one. You know what I'm saying? I raise two hands. Brothers and sisters, if we want to go to Jannah, then we have a long way. We have a long way to go to be admitted into Jannah. And Jannah is the ultimate goal. Because Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala clearly stated, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنَّا وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Whosoever is removed away from the hellfire and admitted into Jannah, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. He is indeed a successful person. So one more time, if you want to go to Jannah, let me see your hand. Remember, I have two hands. Allahu Akbar, mashaAllah. I have no doubt in my mind, looking at these beautiful faces, inshaAllah, Allah will admit us into Jannah. May Allah join us together to Jannah, say Ameen. But brothers, to be honest with you, if you want to go to Jannah, then that you have to deserve. You know what I'm saying? You have to do your best. لن تنال البر حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. Allah said it clearly in Surah Ali Imran, then never shall you attain al-birra, righteousness. And righteousness, you hear, al-birra is al-jannah. Never shall you attain jannah hatta tunfiqu mimma tuhibbun, until you spend in the cause of Allah from that which you love. The wealth that you have. And sometimes when we try to get some money for the pleasure of Allah, and you know better than me, brothers, I came all the way from Texas. So brothers and sisters, don't let me down. I don't want to go and tell the cowboy that we didn't get no money here. You know what I'm saying? I know that there is money in this community, inshallah. All what we have to do is to take a pragmatic approach and pray for our intention, believe in Allah. Put our trust in Allah and spend without hesitation. Sometimes when we call brothers to spend, we are very reluctant and we are not forthcoming to spend. Why? Because we listen to the whisper of Shaitan. And Allah made this clear so that it will not be a surprise to me and you. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala stated clearly in Surah Al-Baqarah, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. الشيطان, the devil, يعدكم الفقر, he promises you, he threatens you with poverty. When it's time for you to spend in the cause of Allah, Shaitan will whisper to your brother, wait a minute, you have to pay your bill, you have to take care of your rent, you have to have your oil changed, you have to change the transmission, and so on and so forth. Ash-shaytan ya'idukum al-faqr. Shaitan threatens you with poverty. And he commands you to commit al-fahsha, to commit sins, and so on and so forth. Whereas Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ya'idukum maghfiratan minhu wa fadla. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala promises you forgiveness from himself and bounty. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is well sufficient for his creatures needs. Alim all night. Let me begin with this because I can talk all night long. And I'm not here to talk. I'm here to take your money. I'm not here to talk, brother. So you can make it very short or you can make it very long. Subhanallah, the choice is yours. So let me begin with this. Remember talking about Jannah? Jannah is about deen. And inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, I want to see one of these beautiful faces. Remember, if you are going to set a good example for the brothers to emulate, whosoever will follow your footsteps to spend, inshallah, you will have a reward of each and every brother and sister who will follow you. Who is going to be there for the youth? Bantu youth summer activities. And we know that we have the children, Wicked Islamic School, and what have you. We have to stand tall and be there and do whatever we can to help the children, the youth, for the pleasure of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We can do that. Let me see who's going to begin with $40,000. Okay. I know you want to raise your hand, but just wait a minute. Just give me 1 second. I know some brothers, mashallah, they are boiling from inside. They want to start. But just give me a second. One thing you have to remember, that sometimes when you want to spend in the cause of Allah, you ask yourself, where is this money going to come from? Where am I going to get this money? Allah will provide. And Allah provides to you every day. All you have to do is to believe in Allah and put your trust in Him. In authentic hadith, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ تَبْدُو خِمَاسًا وَتَرُوحُ بِطَانًا. Ask yourself, who feeds the bird? It's Allah. So put your trust in Allah. I am not asking you to bring forward the 40,000 today. Inshallah, you can pledge, and whatever you can afford, inshallah ta'ala, the brothers will work with you gradually. You can pay it in installment payment, inshallah. So let me see who is going to begin with the $40,000 for the pledge of Allah. This is the way to Jannah, brothers. I just ask you, who wants to go to Jannah? Remember, we have both hands. Aye, so this is the way to Jannah. We have to work hard. Who is going to begin with the 40? I didn't say 400, I said 40, 40. Let me see some hands here. And do not let the sisters start, because I have good experience with the sisters, that they are very instrumental when it comes into spending the cause of Allah. And I mean it. So let me see from the brothers and from the sisters, who is going to begin? This is for the sake of Allah. $40,000 for the sake of Allah. This is for your akhirah, for your hereafter, for your jannah. And remember that whatever you spend, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, not only that He will give you reward, not only that Allah will protect you and save you and your family in dunya, not only that inshallah Allah will admit you into jannah, but Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala yukhlifu. He will replace everything. Every dime that you spend, Allah will replace it. 40,000. Who is going to begin, brothers? Brothers and sisters, who is going to begin with the 40? Am I asking for too much? Is Al-Jannah too much for $40,000? You know what, brothers? If we're going to count here, those of us who own houses, we have a lot of brothers and sisters, mashallah. And this is good, by the way, don't get me wrong. We buy houses, we pay mortgage, and we keep paying. Sometimes we pay with the interest. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the riba. Say ameen. Ameen. We keep paying again and again, on and on. We have no question that we can pay this money. But when it comes to spending the cause of Allah, do not let shaitan keep you away. 40,000, who's going to go for that? The first person who is going to buy the akhirah, the hereafter, which is 40,000. Come on, brothers. Come on, sisters. 40,000, who's going to go for it? Well, I don't want to keep you long. Let me go down. Who's going to give me $30,000 for the pledge of Allah? 30,000. 30,000. I know Al-Jannah is more expensive than this. Jazakallah khair. The Sheikh is here to plead on your behalf that 30 is too up, so I should come down. Okay, brothers, I'm going to go down. Who is going to give Allah $20,000? For the sake of Allah, 20. This is for the sake of Allah. This is your investment. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. All you who believe, shall I guide you to a trade gain that will save you from a painful torment? You should believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and His Messenger. And you should strive in the cause of Allah بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ, with your wealth and your soul and yourself. That is better for you if you but know. 20,000 for the sake of Allah. Let me go down a little bit. 15,000. Brothers of South Carolina. 15,000 for the pledge of Allah. This is for your akhirah. This is for your akhirah, not dunya. 15,000 for the pledge of Allah. You can pay in installments, inshallah.
The brother asking how long will take, you understand? So they can get encouragement to pay. Is it supposed to be paid in a month, in a year, 2 years, 10 years?
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The brother is asking the method of payment, inshallah ta'ala, the brothers will work with you to make it very convenient for you, inshallah. Inshallah, brothers will work with you in the way and manner that will be affordable and convenient for you, inshallah. 15,000 for the pleasure of Allah. Can I see your hand, inshallah? Allahu Akbar, At-Takbir. Come on, brothers and sisters, if you are not going to give me money, you don't want to give me takbir?
Allah.
Takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
I have a brother here, he's giving Allah a loan of $15,000. At-Takbir.
Allah makhlif alayhi. Allah makhlif alayhi.
I would appreciate if someone can take a payment, inshallah ta'ala. I know you know the community, but this is, inshallah, for the sake of
Allah makhlif alayhi.
The record, inshallah.
Allah makhlif alayhi.
This is
one brother here. He is giving a loan to Allah. من الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له أضعافا كثيرة. Who is he who is going to give Allah تبارك وتعالى a goodly loan? And Allah تبارك وتعالى will give it to you back and give you manifold interest. I want another brother or a sister. $15,000 for the sake of Allah. 15,000 brothers and sisters. Don't let us down. This is for your akhirah, for your hereafter. You can pay the installment, inshallah. 15,000. And the brother here, and the sister here, 15,000, inshallah. Let me go down. Who's going to give me 10,000 for the sake of Allah? 10,000 for the sake of Allah. Brothers, we mean business. Allahu Akbar, a takbir. Give me takbir. I want this heart to shake. Give me takbir. I see one of the faces over there. Brothers, give inshallah 10,000 for the pleasure of Allah. The first brother and the second brother, barakallahu fi kuma, wa baraka fi ahli kuma, wa Allah bless you. Allah bless your wealth and bless your family. Amen. Yeah,
amen. Amen.
I want another 10,000 brothers. Another 10,000. But I told you, you can make it very short. The dinner is around the corner, inshallah. But we have to take care of our business first. This is collective duty and individual responsibility. We all have to be part of this good deed. We have to invest with Allah. Who's going to give another 10,000 for the pleasure of Allah? Another 10,000 for the pleasure of Allah. Don't put your head down, because Allah knows that you can afford. Allah knows that you have the means. يقول ابن آدم مالي مالي وإنما له من ماله ثلاث ما أكل فأفنى أو تصدق ما أكل فأفنى أو لبس فأبلى أو تصدق فأمضى وما سوى ذلك فذاهب وتاركه للناس. هذا authentic حديث. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that Allah تبارك وتعالى said, this is حديث القدسي, the divine tradition, that Ibn Adam, the son of Adam, says, Mali, Mali, my wealth, my wealth, my wealth, my property. Why not Allah bin Mali bin Salah? You have only three benefits from your wealth. Ma akala fa afna, what you add and it's gone. That is your wealth. What you put on and it's worn out, your thawb, your pants, your shirt, and it's worn out, that is your wealth. Or what you give in sadaqah and you have the reward, like the brothers compete one another in doing good. Other than that, you're going to go away and leave it for your head. You leave it for your heir, for your family. So you have to take advantage since you are alive and invest with Allah. Another 10,000 brothers. 10,000 dollars. 10,000. If I have another 10,000, I'll go down, inshallah. But I'm trying to work with you brothers to have good deeds. And you can make it. Don't listen to the whisper of shaitan. 10,000 for the sake of Allah. Can I see another hand for brother? One hand, inshallah, another 10,000. Say inshallah, and you can make it. Another 10,000. Brothers, this beautiful face is inshallah. Show Allah the best of you. Show Allah the best of you. And have yaqeen that Allah ta'ala will provide for you. 10,000 for the sake of Allah. Can I have another hand, inshallah ta'ala? Brothers and sisters, 10,000, inshallah. Another 10,000. 10,000 is not too expensive for the Jannah. Our Jannah is more expensive, brothers. 10,000. Another 10,000. Let me give you a breakdown. 9,000. 9,000. I don't want to say 999. No, just keep it 9,000. Who's going to give Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala $9,000? For the sake of Allah, brothers, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam incited the companions to spend their wealth in the cause of Allah. And you know better than me. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, you know what I felt good about? Because it happened that day I have money at home. All the time, Abu Bakr is forthcoming and forgiving. So I felt good because inshallah today I will do better than Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he went home and he brought a lot of money. Half of all his possession, half of his money, he gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, Ya Amr, what did you leave home for your household? He said, I have half of my wealth. I brought half and I have half for my family. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in no time, he came with all his money. Brothers, I'm not asking you to do that. He came with all his money. He gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Ya Abu Bakr, what did you leave for your family? He said, I left for them Allah. I left for them Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is an example of companions. They believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And more examples like Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu and other companions, they compete one another in doing righteous good deeds. Who will give me 9,000 for the pleasure of Allah? And this is alone, by the way, you're giving Allah alone. 9,000. Brothers, we can stay longer inshallah and we can make Maghrib later. And we can make it shorter and have our dinner inshallah. The choice is ours, right? So make it easy for me and you. Who will give Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala $8,000? $8,000. I'm trying to make it easy, brothers. I understand. $8,000, brothers and sisters. $8,000 for the sake of Allah. Is there any sister who will give Allah alone? Huh? $8,000 for the sake of Allah. Alright, let me calm down. Who will give Allah 5,000? Can I have inshallah 5,000 for the pleasure of Allah? $5,000 for the sake of Allah. This is for your Jannah. Is there any sister who will buy Jannah with 5,000? Only 5,000. Jannah inshallah with the $5,000. Brothers and sisters, 5,000. This is for your Akhirah. For the pleasure of Allah. We have a brother here who is donating 15,000. We have a brother who is donating 10,000. Brothers, we need more. Inshallah, 5,000. Who's gonna go for that, inshallah? I see brothers smile, and I believe that inshallah when they smile, the good will come, inshallah. 5,000 for the sake of Allah. 5,000 for the sake of Allahu Akbar. At-takbir. I told you, when you see brothers smiling, then you know that inshallah, the good news is coming. The glad tidings is coming. Brothers, we have a long way to go. I'm not stopping here. And don't tell me that it's time, just give me half more time. We just have 15 and 15 over there, so we have 10. Brothers, I need another 5,000. Barakallahu fika wa baraka fi ahlika wa mali. May Allah bless you and bless your wealth and bless your family. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
MashaAllah, I love to hear that. Say Ameen again.
Ameen.
Who will give Allah 5,000? Don't give it to me, give it to Allah. This is alone. And Allah will give it to you back. And listen to this ayah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Munafiqun, بعد عوذ الله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون. This is Quran.
Sheikh, would you be kind enough to repeat it again? Let this hearts get soft a little bit. We want to hear this Quran.
This is Quran. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la tulhikum amwalukum La tulhikum amwalukum wa la awladukum an dhikrillah Wa man yaf'al dhalika fa ulaika humul khasirun Wa anfiqu mimma razaqnakum أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون
This is in Surah Al-Munafiqun يا أيها الذين آمنوا or you who believe لا تلهكم أموالكم وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Let not your wealth or your children divert you and keep you away from the remembrance of Allah. And while your wealth, your offspring, let not, don't allow them, don't give them a chance to keep you away from the remembrance of Allah. Salah and righteous good deeds. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ Whoever will do that, in other words, whosoever will allow his wealth and children to keep him away from the remembrance of Allah and doing righteous good deeds, he will be one of the losers. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمَ الْخَاسِرُونَ This is introduction. What comes next is what is of paramount importance to you and I. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ And spend from that which we have bestowed to you. That which we provided for you. So the wealth that you have is from Allah. And Allah has given it to you as amanah, it's a trust. And you know what? On the day of resurrection, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is one of the questions that Allah will ask you. Is your wealth? Where did you attain all this wealth? And how did you spend your wealth? Where did you get it? And where did you spend it? So subhanAllah, if you spend it in the good cause, you have good answer to tell Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. But if you don't, you have to prepare for your impending question. أَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ Spend from that which Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala provided for you before death comes to one of you. فَيَقُولَ And then one will say, رَبِّي مَا لَوْلَا أَخْرَجْتَنِي I wish that you give me respite. وَاللَّهِ give me second chance. Give me another chance. إِلَى أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ And at the time of death, one is not asking to come to dunya to do some kind of business or buy another house or buy SUV and so on and so forth. لا فَأَصَّدَّقَ Oh Allah, give me a second chance. And guess what? Allah, I will surprise you. I will surprise you if we're going to have fundraiser. I'm going to give all my wealth in sadaqah. Brother, you was here when we were talking. Who is going to go to Jannah? I want to see your hands, because we have two hands. But give the wealth, and then you put your hand back. But now you want a second chance. فَأَصَّدَّقَ I will give my wealth in sadaqah, and I will be one of the righteous. فلن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها. الله تبارك وتعالى will not give you respite. Allah will not give you a second chance when your appointed time is due. But this is the time to spend the gospel of Allah. Give me 5,000 brothers. Give me 5,000, you give it to Allah alone. I see some smiling faces again, Allahu Akbar. Whenever I see smiling faces, I know the good is coming. 5,000, this is alone to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. 5,000 for the pledge of Allah. Brother, I just read the ayah to you. If you didn't listen to the ayah, and when it's time for you to depart the life of the world, and then the angel will say to you, you forgot what the brother read the ayah to you, but you're like, oh man, he just said that. He just wants to take my money. No, I'm trying to let you invest for your akhirah, brothers and sisters. 5,000 for the sake of Allah. 5,000 for the sake of Allah. 5,000 is not too much for the Jannah. 5,000 for the sake of Allah. I'm not going to stop. 5,000 inshallah. Any sister here will give Allah alone? 5,000 inshallah for the sake of Allah? 5,000 for the sake of Allah? 5,000 for the sake of Allah. I want one hand inshallah. For the sake of Allah, and this is alone. Let me give you a discount again. More discount? 4,000. 4,000, this is alone to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Don't get tired, brothers. Al-Jannah is not easy. We have to spend. We have to strive. We have to do more. And on the day of resurrection, while you are in Jannah, may Allah give us Jannah, say Ameen. Ah, now you don't want to say Ameen for Jannah again? May Allah admit us to Jannah, say Ameen.
Ameen.
Brothers, you will regret living in Jannah. Because Jannah is darajat. Different level of abode, as the hellfire is the rakat. So when you are in Jannah, you will regret and wish that you would have done better and wish that you have done more for the sake of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. 4,000 for your Jannah, 4,000 in the cause of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And now 4,000 here, I say alone inshallah. And the brothers are waiting for me to come. Brother, you are weird. Out, come down, come down. I understand that. But I'm trying to maximize your reward, inshallah ta'ala. Give me 3,000 for the sake of Allah. 3,000 brothers. You know what? We had a fundraising in Austin, Texas. When we came to the gathering, and I look around, the brothers, I'm very serious. Handful of brothers. I mean, not more than 20. So they asked me to come and get money. I said, subhanAllah. What are the brothers? 20 brothers, where is the money coming from? But I said in my heart, كم من فئة قليلة؟ غلب الفئة الكثيرة بإذن الله. It's not about quantity, but the quality. Because Allah تبارك وتعالى is able to do miracles. So sometimes you have only few people, a handful, but they will defeat a large number. Brothers, we finished the fundraiser with $155,000. You cannot believe it. I started with $40,000. And two brothers, two friends sitting next to each other. So after the introduction, I said, brothers, you do this for your akhirah. And I know that we don't have money. But inshallah, with good intention, Allah will make it easy for us, inshallah. Who is going to give Allah alone? One brother, and he is a new convert, reverted to Islam. A good young brother. I said, who is going to give Allah alone of 40,000? Wallahi al-Azim, brothers. In less than 3 minutes, he raised his hand. $40,000. And next to him, his friend. He said, whoa, if my friend can give 40, I can also do the same. So his friend raised his hand. Two brothers with an 80,000, right? And the target was 30,000. I said, no. Because we have food, so I can talk more. You know what I'm saying? I know at the end of the day, I'm going to eat. So I have to give more energy before I will eat. Anyway, brothers, 155,000. Only 20 brothers. But this beautiful faces, inshallah ta'ala, I know and I believe that we can do that. Who's going to give Allah $1,000? Raise your hand, brother. I want you to show Allah the best of you. $1,000. A takbir. Brothers, give me some takbir, brothers. A takbir. I know this brother will do that. This is my son-in-law. A takbir. I know he will do that, man. Subhanallah. And subhanallah, you know what? We did Jummah khutbah. And he was one of the brothers who was giving and giving. I said, Ibrahim, it's okay. Don't spend all because I need some money for grocery. He's a very good brother. May Allah bless him and give you more. Say, I mean. I'm giving the same dua for you too. I have the same dua for you too. Who's going to give Allah $1,000? That's alone. But make sure you take his name, inshallah, and take his number. Is there any brother who's going around, inshallah? Take the names and take the numbers, inshallah. Who's going to give Allah $1,000, brothers? Don't let me down. See, even the young children are raising their hands, subhanallah. Who's going to give Allah $1,000? Sisters, let me turn around here. I know that you want to go to Jannah. Let me see those who want to go to Jannah, sisters. Let's go. Allahu Akbar. You know what? In here after we have only two homes. It's only Jannah or the hellfire. Let me see those who want to go to Jannah. Jannah, sisters. MashaAllah. Allahu Akbar. Now I want $1,000. At takbir.
Allahu
Akbar. And this is what the sahabiyat, the female companions used to do. They don't let the sahaba, all the brothers take their reward. They say, no, you know what? What men can do, women can do better. And this is what we want to see as an example. We want to see sisters who will be forthcoming and giving to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And giving generously to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Can I have another thousand for the sake of Allah? From the sisters, inshallah, and the brothers? Another thousand? A thousand for the sake of Allah? What are the brothers? At-takbir. At-takbir. Inshallah, we get in there, brothers. We get in there. I still have some time. We get in there, inshallah. Another thousand for the sake of Allah. At-takbir. At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
And now you can show Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala the best of you. Like I said, brothers, at the end of the day, I don't want to go home and tell the cowboys that, you know what, there is no money in South Carolina. I don't believe that. I know there is money here, you know what I'm saying? And you guys can do better. So let's show Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala the best of us. Can I have another thousand for the pleasure of Allah? Brothers, wallahi al-azim, if you know the reward that you earn by giving this thousand, I know you will not stop giving. But inshallah, I understand that you want to give your brothers a chance so that they will all compete in doing good, inshallah. Thousand for the sake of Allah. At-takbir. Brothers, give me the takbir, please. At-takbir. There we go. Alhamdulillah, I see brothers coming on now, mashallah. A thousand for the sake of Allah. Another thousand for the sake of Allah. At-takbir.
Allahu
Akbar. That's the Shaykh, the son of the Shaykh. Allahu Akbar. At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. Naam. We want to see brothers. We want to see Rijal, not Dhukur. That is different between Rijal and Dhukur. Dhukur is just like male. And now we want to see men. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا We want to see examples of men who will come forward and give generously to Allah تبارك وتعالى. And by the way, even if you give, you can give again this morning. What? Don't say, oh, you know, I already gave, so no. يعني زيادة الخير خيرين. You give, you can give again. I'm not going to stop you because it's more good to you, inshallah. Another thousand, inshallah. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Now, I know that, brothers. I know the good is coming, inshallah. Allahu Akbar. Another thousand for the sake of Allah. Another thousand. Brothers, we can do it. We can do better. We can do better. Another thousand for the sake of Allah.
I don't want to, you know, I have a habit sometimes when I try to get money from the brothers, because I love you so much, you know what I do sometimes? I go around and say, you, Thousand. You, Thousand. I don't want to do that. I don't want to be bad. You know what I'm saying? And I'm doing that because I love you. So when I point you that you have Thousand to give to Allah, please don't think that I hate you. No, I'm doing it because I don't want you to lag behind. You know what I mean? I don't want you to stay back. I want you to come forth, inshallah ta'ala, and give it to Allah. And Allah tabarakah wa ta'ala will appreciate that. Thousand for the sake of Allah, a takbir.
How much more you got to go? How much more money you want?
Sheikh, whatever you can give me, Sheikh.
No. I'm asking how much more you want to get? Because we're going to make you assign people now, okay?
Okay, Allahu Akbar.
How much do you want?
Allahu Akbar. Sheikh is going to help me to assign some people. Sheikh, if you can give me, inshallah, 20, I will start.
20 what?
20,000.
Dollars?
Am I asking for too much, Sheikh? I'm sorry about that, Sheikh.
Let's try to get half of it, okay?
Okay, I'll make a deal with you, Sheikh. Give me 15. Let's make a deal, Sheikh. 15. Then if I have 15 brothers, inshallah, we open with the shop. Okay? So I need 15 hands, and inshallah, it's going to be a done deal. And then inshallah ta'ala, we're going to make salat, and then we'll move on, inshallah.
15 brothers?
15 brothers, or you can distribute between brothers and sisters.
Okay.
I want 15 hands.
Alright.
Let me see. From now, it counts down. So don't sit back, inshallah. Make sure that you will be part of this caravan. This is count down to 15, okay? 15 down to 1. Who's going to go first, inshallah?
Let's make 10,000, brother. Let's
okay, brother, I'll go with you, Sheikh.
Salat al-Maghrib and the people hungry.
Okay, Sheikh, let's go with 10. Only 10 hands, inshallah.
10,000, okay?
Okay, only 10 hands, inshallah, and then we're going to end with that, inshallah. Who's going to give me 1,000, inshallah, for the sake of Allah? 1,000 dollars, brothers and sisters, for the sake of Allah. Only 10 hands, and if I have one brother who will give me the 10, I will stop there, inshallah. 1,000 for the sake of Allah.
Assign people. Let's assign people.
Help me do that, Sheikh. Yes. We need 10 hands, inshallah. 10 hands, inshallah.
This number one.
Allahu Akbar. Naam, going one. Allahu Akbar. At-takbir. Help me with the takbir, brothers.
Allahu Akbar.
Takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
I assigned 3 people already.
Alhamdulillah, 3 is gone. We have 7 to go.
7 to go?
This 7 to go.
This is mine, okay?
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
We have 6 to go.
6 to go?
What 6 to go, brothers.
What about 500, brother? 500?
If 500, then we'll have 10 again, brother.
Let's start with 500, okay?
Let's go with 500, inshallah.
Let's start with 500, inshallah.
500, inshallah.
Let's start with 500, inshallah.
500, brothers. Chef, there is one hand in the back.
One in the back.
I don't know whether he wants to go with the 1,000 or with the 5.
Yeah, but sisters here. Friend.
Sisters, Allahu Akbar, Chef. I have some sisters in the back here. Jazakumullah khair, Naam. Jazakumullah khair, sister. Naam. Still more, Chef?
Yes, sir. We have 500 more here.
Naam.
So you still have to offer 600 more.
Sayyid, 500 brothers for the sake of Allah. Allah Akbar. 500 for the sake of Allah. I have a hand here, Sheikh.
Allahu Akbar.
At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Naam. Let this envelope go.
Can help me with the sisters, please? Assign sisters. Who really to assign sisters?
At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
At-takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
We have 3 envelopes to go, inshallah. It's only 5 now.
We have one sister here, so we have 4 more to go.
It's only 5 now.
We have 4 more to go. Four more to go?
Four more to go.
We have the one here.
So four more to go. Takbir. We have 3 more to go or 4 more to go. Now. 500.
All right. We have 3 more to go.
Coming in the door.
3 more to go. 3 more to go. 500 for the sake of Allah.
3 more to go. 3 more to go.
3 more to go.
You want to eat the dinner? 3 more to go.
Only 3 more to go.
Suhaila, give it to the sister behind you right away, straight.
Allahu Akbar.
Here.
3 more to go, brothers.
Give all of this. Here.
go.
Two more to go, brothers.
If you want to eat dinner, you want to pray.
For the sake of Allah, we have only two more to go. Sheikh, God is good enough. Give him one or two. If he wants more, it's ajr. Give him more, as much as he wants. Barakallahu feekum, barakallahu fee ahlikum, barakallahu. Two more to go.
Two more to go.
Two more to go.
Come on, guys, want to pray.
Alhamdulillah.
I have 200. One more to go.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. Sheikh, his hand behind me. Allahu Akbar. Told you, Sheikh. The brother is given 15,000.
Speak up. Up, loud. Everybody can. Muhammad. Muhammad.
I'm trying to get the boy to say it, they don't say anything.
There is a volume up. There is a volume in the speaker up. The mic is not working.
Brothers and sisters, please speak very, very quiet. Because we have real questions up here that can't compete with us in any way unless you listen. So if you could please ask you to be very, very still with our mouths, with our tongues right now. So,
Anissa. Anissa.
Sit down, sit down. Sit.
Just call me.
small bag on my desk. I think I do. Did you leave a small notepad on my desk? Here, on the table, you show.
Get
to
a dozen
and come back. Okay. Okay,
Oh.
for us to show up. And we'd like to thank all of you for making those involved in the project for the support, the generous support tonight in Baltimore City. And I want to thank you.
Thank you, Brother Mazzani, for being here. Our principal, Wilson. The cameraman, Mr. Bowie. Thank you for everybody that I brought you. And on behalf of all of you, I would like to present this humble gift as a token of appreciation for our guest speaker tonight. The Imam, inshallah, from the Deen, that Allah khair, be appreciated again. That Allah khair. And again, we say, طلع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله ذا
خلينا نسمعك يا شباب
طلع
Oh, you see you? السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.